Nothing makes my heart full like imagining two clumsy boys trying to kiss mouth to mouth for the first time. Moomin troll, bless his heart, only knows what a moomin kiss is like. Snufkins never really kissed anyone in any regard. So it just starts with a hand underneath Moomin's snout to tilt it up as two nervous shivering pairs of lips try to find each other. Then they meet and their jaws press together, sealing the warm air inside their mouths. It's awkward and doesn't feel too great at first, but it only gets softer and warmer and the little gasps and shudders they make only force each other to keep at it. And then as they pull apart and their lips close, they have the familiar taste and sensation of each other. Each of them getting close and intimate to the cavern that forms sweet saccharine words such as I love you and you're my dearest. And each kiss steals the words from their mouth and they swallow it down deep into their bellies so that they'll know what love feels like forever. You know, guys being guys. Moomin Troll and Snufkin are gay. Discuss.
Not much to discuss when you're just spitting straight facts. Or rather, gay facts. They like to hold paws, you wah. Snufkin has little tiny paws and Moomin has nice paw pads.
Ah, Moom's big white polar bear paw eclipses Snuff's tiny cat paw.
Okay. One night Snuff has some nightmares like the little baby twink he is. Boom, Moomin is also in bed because they gay as fuck. Moomin wakes up and asks if he's okay and he's like, no bro, come on. So, big brain moment at Moomin, he's like, let me sing him to sleep, cause this season proved he's a good singer, so that brassy voice.
Soothing.
Moomin swaddles Snuff in a blanket and holds him in his lap and rocking softly as he's singing. Snuff feels the vibration rumble on his back and he's like, oh yeah, this is calming. Moomin keeps singing long after he's asleep, then he'll be like, oh okay, and continue nuzzling him in the bed.
Ooh, my heart hurted. Good show, good fluff.
HHHGGGG, my heart, yes, I love this. Okay, so mine is 1 year. Snufkin decides to let Moomin travel with him and realizes he might need some boots for the extended travel. However, hardy Moomin says his feet are. Moomin agrees somewhat reluctantly, only to reveal he can't tie his laces cause his paws are too large and clumsy. But Snufkin is just like, oh, let me do that, with his tiny dexterous fingies, and ties the neatest bows every time, and Moomin is just so gay for that.
I'm gonna scream, helpful boyfriend.
Snuff is really good with his hands, huh?
In your room, you say?
But really, though, Moomin is the only one Snufkin allows to touch him with such frequency. There's something very soothing about a soft marshmallow boyfriend with smooth fur, and he may be a bit clumsy, but the pressure he puts on Snufkin's weary bones every time he's in need of something to satisfy his skin hunger or calm his anxious nerves more than makes up for it. Sometimes at night when Snufkin can't sleep, he goes to Moomin's house and invites Moomin to cuddle and spoon him in his tent, so he can feel the soft cushion of Moomin's chest and torso against his spine as stubby little fingers run down his arms. He's calm now. Why is this such a mood? This is such a soothing thought in general. I want a Moomin to spoon me too.
My heart be fluttering dough.
Moomins are made of love and pancakes.
Are Moomins edible?
Only Snufkin knows.
In your room, you say?
Oh, Snufkin.
Snufkin, damn. I wonder if Jockster knows too.
Oh, you know he does.
God, if he wasn't such a smelly creature already, I'd feel a bit sorry for plunging into that ass. You just know Moomin Papa has to have Mama wipe for him. His arms are too short, he can't reach. There are some things Moomin and Snuff can keep to themselves. Little things, things you don't really notice until looking closely. Like the way Moomin hops from foot to foot when he wants to show Snufkin something he found, or the slight lilt to Snufkin's harmonica tune when he's flustered. Little Mai, as determined as she is, won't be able to find out just what they keep from her. They're very good at keeping secrets. You got stinky papa in my fluff, why?
Sorry, I apologize deeply.
Deeply.
Don't make me tap the sign.
You say?
Ugh, the secret little things is almost canon, though, with them having their little whistles and stuff.
Yes, it's adorable.
Whistling outside the window in the middle of the night be pretty damn gay.
Truly.
Also them sharing a room when Snufkin hibernated with them.
And the anime they shared a bed.
Did they? That's hella gay though.
Yes, they just sleep together, no break, full on gay. This bitch tells Snufkin not to sleep outside, so he sleeps with Moomin, and they whisper to each other under the sheets.
With the softest, most romantic music, while they giggle and laugh.
Bro, what if we shared a bed together during hibernation, haha? Unless...
found this comment.
Why do degenerates gotta make misinterpretations from innocent cartoon characters?
Bro, they are in the same bed. How is that misinterpreting? I mean, you can go home if you're not having fun.
OMG, they are sharing beds. Stop misinterpreting greater than. Sorry folks, they gay.
How can you not see this and think this is gay? Two boys spending a whole day under the covers together. Snufkin runs his hands over Moomin, who giggles because he's ticklish. They nuzzle noses and lace fingers and tails together. They kiss until they're breathless. They'd be content to stay tangled up all day, but their stomachs call for food. They're lucky though that Mama has a lunch already prepared and on the way up to the room, so once they finish it they can get back to staring into soft warm eyes all day.
Nothing like snuggling up with your asshole all day.
This is so soft, I'm weeping. Ugh, my poor soft little heart. After this scene, Snufkin probably tells his stories until Moomin falls asleep listening to them, and then he just stares into the dark room and feels super alone again. Even though Moomin is right next to him, he just feels disconnected from everyone and has a very hard time trying to sleep himself. Until Moomin rolls over and cuddles up around him, and instantly things feel a lot better, and he spends a while just rubbing circles into Moomin's fur until he eventually falls asleep himself.
Damn, this hurt me right here, as you can see by me putting my hand on my chest.
I feel like us guys can all relate to sleep disordered Snufkin too much. I feel it in my soul. Brings me to the conclusion that Snufkin is only really on a set sleeping schedule to be able to be with Moomin. Otherwise he'd just sleep when he's too exhausted to continue and be awake any other moment.
Oh no, that's too real.
Moomin should worry about Snufkin's late night walks, cause it sounds like he's avoiding sleep. I'm sure when he finds out the cause, he is just about the cuddles and helps him feel safe and comfy. I can't stay away from even making Fluff angsty. I need to be controlled.
But hey, sometimes a little touch of angst makes the fluff fluffier. Hurt comfort is a whole genre for this reason.
It's true. It's like garnish.
You could have a sweet tooth rotting cake, but you can have a touch of sourness or bitterness to make the taste more complex, and it helps you appreciate the sweet even more.
Yeah, ooh, like a strawberry cake where the strawberries are just a bit tart.
Exactly. Or a vanilla cake with lemon.
Oh, yeah, now I'm just hungry. Puffed.
Mama makes such wonderful treats, but she needs taste testers. Moomin and Snufkin are happy to oblige, but they get playful with it. They get cream on their cheeks and lick it off, savoring the taste even more. They even feed each other their samples, and as their shoulders press together, they melt into each other, because the food is so good, and the proximity the two have to each other is by far the best touch of flavor. There's nothing quite like feeding your friend some cakes that would be beautiful on their own but are seasoned by love.
This is so sweet, and Mama probably just watches her son and son-in-law with a huge smile, cause they are both so happy and enjoying themselves and they like her treats, and Snufkin is always showering her baking with compliments. She probably calls on them on purpose to give them a little time to themselves, much to Sniff's chagrin.
I could scream, that's too cute. And when neither of them can eat another bite, they shower Mama with compliments while they have their arms around each other, now cozy and warm after so much good food, and now they just wanna become puddles and melt into each other together.
This is so good. They fall asleep on the couch, both with faces still messy, curled up together, all intertwined, and Mama doesn't have the heart to wake them, so she wipes them clean with a warm washcloth, very gentle to not disrupt them, and puts a blanket over them. After that, she goes outside with the rest of her snacks and uses them to distract anyone who tries to go in the house.
Haha, yes, and while little Maya and Sniff may feel slighted, at least they won't be interrupting two cuddly boys.
They are clueless as to what's going on, but Maya knows something's up and she wants to get her nose in it, but won't because she loves and respects Mama too much to directly go around her, so she just stews and gets Sniff revved up even if he has no clue what's going on. He's just pleased because sweets.
And Snork Maiden tries to discourage the two of them with some tea to go with those cakes, so the boys get to cuddle as long as they wish.
Snork Maiden just knows, she hasn't seen them all day, so she's like, they doing something together, let's let them be. She invites them over to her house. Snork probably starts saying something about Moomin and Snufkin not being there, and she steps on his foot.
Too much sweetness for my. She is just going to eat the cookies she stole elsewhere, because they're being kissy and lovey and bling.
She sneaks in and immediately gags and scurried away.
Lol, that's what you get, my.
The ultimate protection against cookie theft.